Hello, thank you for clicking on this video. In this video, I would like to share five things, lessons, if you will, that I learned throughout college, which I believe helped me go from being a student that was barely passing, and I mean barely passing, especially in the sciences like math, in physics and biology, to somebody that ended up being able to get an A on Calculus 1 in college. Number one, this is going to sound a bit trivial. However, I think it's one of those very simple things that actually has a very, very big impact. And that's reading your textbooks. Around my senior year of college, I decided to live at home again to save on money because my rent would have increased. So I just decided to save on money because I was already paying for my own tuition and live at home. But that meant a much further commute to the campus. And so I drove half of the way, and then the other half, I drove about 20 minutes, and then I had another about 30 minutes, 25 to 30 minutes bus drive. And I decided to start reading my textbooks before my lectures. And this proved to be monumentally helpful. First of all, you don't have to read the textbooks and consume everything the first round. But what will happen is, as you slowly read the chapter, you'll already have questions. You'll be slightly more familiar with the material. So when the professor or the teacher starts explaining concepts, you'll already be one step further than somebody that knowledge is completely new to. You already have built some of that registry in your brain. Your brain will already start categorizing the new bit of information. Again, it sounds like something that is very trivial and I think very often overlooked, but the benefit is really tremendous. And again, I would like to emphasize that you really do not have to do this perfectly. In fact, you don't have to do anything perfectly. I probably should add a sixth item, and that is aim for imperfection, but I won't do that. But anyways, you really do not have to be perfect in this. You really just want to read it. And I mean, just slowly read it. You also don't have to worry about consuming or remembering all the information or memorizing any of their information. You just want to read it. You just want to sit there and slowly read it and let your brain find its rhythm as you read it. Number two, start failing at home. I think I was probably a junior in college, and I was sitting on my couch in my apartment, just procrastinating and watching some videos. And one video that I watched was an interview of the godfather of skateboarding, Rodney Mullen. He invented the ollie and the kickflip. In this interview, something that stood out to me was that Rodney Mullen emphasized falling. He didn't talk about the moments that he landed his tricks. He just kept on talking about all the crazy number of times he had to fall in order to achieve a trick. This gave me a realization that I wasn't failing enough. I was so focused on perfection and I was so focused on getting good grades that it didn't dawn on me that, you know what, why don't I fall more? Why don't I fail more? And this proved to be very, very fruitful. I was taking a very advanced mathematical statistics course at that time. And I said, you know what, let me see how many ways I can get my homework questions wrong. And then that opened up a whole new world of understanding the material for me, because now I knew what led to the answer being wrong. And oftentimes that's a good technique to figuring out what is the right way. You don't even have to know the right way. You just need to know what are all the wrong ways. And then oftentimes the only way that's left is the right way. So yes, so I think doing your homework and failing at your homework at home is a very important and helpful thing that helped me go from being an F student to being an A student. Number three, viewing exams like sporting matches. I'm not sure when in college, but at some point I was looking at my friends who were top athletes. I felt kind of bummed out that I wasn't more athletic. I said, I wonder how I can apply their framework of thinking to what I was doing. Because after all, when we are studying for a test, we're preparing for essentially a match. Just like in sport, your skill will be tested on match day. In exams, your skills will be tested on that exam. Coach John Wooden was a really renowned basketball coach that coached the UCLA men's basketball team. And I'm not 100% sure, but I think he won them more than 10 national championships. A few things that he did with his basketball students that stood out to me and resonated with my earlier lesson of applying sports thinking to my studying was that he told his players to redefine success. He said, if you walk off the basketball court feeling to your core that you had done everything possible to prepare, if you can walk off knowing to your core that you had done everything in your will to prepare for that match, then you have won. And this really helped me in my own way, because I took this and said to myself, if I can walk out of an exam and feel to my core and in my heart of hearts that I had done everything in my power or everything that I knew to do, if I'd done all those things to prepare for that exam, regardless of the score of the exam, I can walk out there knowing that I succeeded in that exam. Another important thing that he taught his basketball players was to not look at the scoreboard throughout the match. He said, that's not the point. The point is to do your best and play your best while you're on the court. The score will be there regardless. When you walk off the match, you can then look at the score. And I took that and said the same thing. You know, I used to, in the middle of an exam, if I saw that there was a question that counted for a fifth of the final score, and I knew I was struggling on that, I'll be like already trying to calculate the impact of that on my final grade. But when I learned this, I stopped doing that. And I said, you know what, I'm just going to focus on doing my best in the exam, whether there's a question that's going to stump me or not. If I just focus on applying myself in that test and forget about the score, then maybe some good things will happen. And you know what, good things did happen. I can recall a really difficult upper level economics course, which wherein that exact thing happened. I came across a question that really stumped me, but I noticed my heart rate starting to rise because I was already thinking, oh no, this was gonna impact my score. But I caught myself in doing that and I said, you know what? I'm not gonna think about the score. My heart rate came down and I was able to start thinking more clearly. And I actually ended up figuring out that question and ended up getting a really good score in that exam. Number four. And this kind of closely ties in with number three, but that is being very honest with yourself. There's this concept called intellectual integrity and intellectual honesty. And it's really important because we can often get caught up in what's called success theater. Maybe that's by telling your friends you got 100 on a quiz, but the quiz only counts 1/16th of your final score, then while that 100% isn't really gonna make a big difference. The smartest people that I know are extremely intellectually honest. And one way that I kind of manifested that it was by telling myself, you know what, if I cannot do a math problem at home by myself, then I'm probably not going to be able to figure it out on the test. I often would try and avoid knowing that I'm not able to do a math problem and tell myself, oh, you know what, I'm going to figure it out on the test. But 9 out of 10 times, that's not going to be the case. Number five, good planning. Usually the first week of school is going to be syllabus week. So what you want to do is you want to take your syllabus and you want to sit down with your calendar or your planner. And you want to go through each syllabus and you want to take out all the key deadlines like assignment due dates, quiz dates, homework due dates, and exam dates. And you want to put that all into your planner, all up front. And then what you want to do is you want to create a weekly schedule. So one technique that I was taught is to take a regular sheet of paper. It doesn't have to have lines on it. And that is folding it in half. So folding it in half, and then folding it in half again, and then one more time. Try and do this properly. Into a little square, You then unravel it. You take a pen, and on those crease marks, you mark, you go over with your pen, you draw on those crease marks. So now you have a grid, and then you're simply going to put, you're simply going to take, let's see, what's the right orientation? You're simply going to just put the date, the day of the week. So today is Thursday. So I'm just going to write Thursday. I'm going to write the date. So 21st. So you're going to write Thursday, Friday. All right. So you're just simply going to, and I messed this bottom one up, but you're simply just going to write out, you're going to write out the day and the date, and then there you have some lines where you can start writing in your task. So then you can take your other planner, and if you know you've got an exam, something like that. That's extremely, extremely, extremely helpful. It just gives you a peace of mind that you know that you don't have to try and keep everything in your head. It's out there on paper. So, all right. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you can take some of these lessons so that you yourself can go from being an F student to being an A student. And I understand it is really difficult. It is really stressful. It is really painful, but it is possible. Thank you for watching.